Carbon, the seventh element on the periodic table, is a wonderful element. It's in anything that is alive or was alive. Carbon is in coal and slate rocks and even a shiny diamond. Carbon has a bad name these days because there's 50% more of it up in the atmosphere than there was 200 years ago, and it's causing climate problems. Don't forget, we are a carbon-based planet. The forest is full of carbon in the trees and the wildflowers and all the plants and in this beautiful leaf mold that's on the forest floor. So years of leaves dropping have left this pleasantly earthy smelling leaf mold that gardeners have long relished to put into their compost piles and on their beds. Nature's beauty has great intelligence in it. The organic in organic gardening refers to carbon. We copy nature when we make humus in our compost piles. Any rotting plant life or anything that was alive can be put into the compost pile. We use garden refuse and old hay and things like that nature with soils and things from the kitchen garden scraps and all that stuff. We mix it up and we make compost, which then has lots of carbon in it that we put back onto our soils. We also like to add wood chips, but only if they're rotten. Otherwise, it takes too long for them to break down. These wood chips are 7 or 8 years old, and they don't look like wood chips anymore. They have totally rotted down and are ready to put into the compost pile. Wow, look at all that fungal activity. You can't tell that these were wood chips. All this white stuff is the fungal activity that's breaking down the wood chips and creating microbes that will make our soils so much healthier. The final compost is a rich black dirt that smells earthy like the forest floor. Another way to get carbon in your garden is to just grow it right there. This field of crimson clover will add lots of organic matter to this soil here. The Great Plains soils were made great by bison alternatively grazing it and leaving their wastes and then moving on and letting that field grow back up. All that growth then is sequestering carbon, which then gets put into the soil when the animals tromped it back in. We mimic this by growing the cover crops and mowing them and putting them back into the soil. These soils of the Great Plains had 10 or 12% organic matter, and that's a lot of carbon and a lot of carbon ingesting microorganisms. In these situations, the carbon is coming from the air and going into the soil, which is really what we want to happen. When a soil has less than 2% organic matter, which is quite common today in many of the world's soils that have been artificially fertilized, we've killed the soil microbes, and consequently, there's nothing in the soil to ingest the carbon and bring it back in from the atmosphere into the soil. Although humans have put carbon into the atmosphere by burning fossil fuels, scientists now know that humans can take carbon back out of the atmosphere and put it into the soil. We do this with regenerative farming, which follows nature's way by letting the grass grow, intensively grazing it with ruminants, like these cows, and then letting it grow up again with no animals on it. The advantage to lots of carbon and a high organic matter in your soil are many. The soil is so much easier to work, and it holds much more moisture, but then again, it will dry out quicker in the spring. The soil is teeming with the life-giving microbes that plants need to grow healthily. Another advantage to having carbon in your soil is that it forms carbonic acid with the rainwater, and this carbonic acid then is capable of dissolving the minerals that are locked up in rocks. Mulching instead of tilling also conserves carbon. This field of garlic is mulched with hay, which then adds the valuable organic matter to the soil, and besides keeping the soil moist, also protects it from the sun, and that helps to protect the carbon in the soil. Your small organic garden is actually helping to reverse climate change. Grow cover crops, make compost, till less and mulch more, and you are building up the organic matter in your soil and sequestering carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. You're growing microbes in your garden that eat carbon constantly. And another advantage to having lots of carbon in your garden is that you and your plants will be healthier.
For inspiring garden tours, growing tips, and garden projects, visit our website at volunteergardener.org or on YouTube at the Volunteer Gardener channel and like us on Facebook.